Hey guys, and thanks for watching Book Haters, where we judge movies by their covers. Only on YouTube. Hi, I'd like to thank everybody who subscribed since the last one episode that I made. Thank you all my friends from Chula Vista and my cousin. So today we're going to be dealing with number 99 on the American Film Institute list, which is Guess Who's Coming to Dinner. This movie came out in 1967 and it'll run you at an hour and 48 minutes, which is probably as long as the trailer if you check it out. If you click right here on this link, the one right here, that one. If I don't do the special effects, I'm sorry. The plot in this movie, okay, get this, okay? Get this. There's this girl, and she brings her fiancé, who's a doctor, to the house. Her parents are very rich, so it's very difficult for them to approve of somebody. So now this girl wants her parents to approve about this doctor, right? But there's a problem. He's black. Now, this movie's starring some key figures of this time.
Starring Academy Award winner Spencer Tracy, Academy Award winner Katharine Hepburn, introducing Katherine Houghton, Academy Award winner Sidney Poitier.
I speak Spanish, dude. I can say Poitier, you know? It's not my tío Poitier.
Or Sidney Poitier.
Poitier?
Or Sidney Poitier.
Ah, whatever. I'll use the other takes. So this is the cover. I was looking for the most original cover that they had. I'm guessing this is it. Now, Rotten Tomatoes gave this a 63%, which is something that I'm probably going to give it. And Flixster gave it an 85%, which is an awesome year to be born in. And that's it. Any other info you want to get, click on the links below. And I'll be back sooner than you think. Thanks for watching and please subscribe. This review's really gonna suck. There's not that much stuff to make fun of. Like, the racism stuff's, like, not even that funny. I don't know. I find it hard to make fun of racism, you know? Because, you know, it's just not right.
John Wade Prentice. Isn't that a lovely name? John Wade.
Everybody kind of disapproves about what they're doing, starting off with the mom's friend.
Mrs. St. George, I'd like you to meet Dr. Prentice.
Dr. Prentice, I'm so pleased to meet you.
Then the mom.
Well, I suppose it would be all right if I said, my goodness.
Then the dad, who kind of looks like the guy from Up. Then the maid. The only one that kind of approves is the priest.
You'll actually need me. Otherwise, your side won't even outnumber the blacks.
The maid's really funny. She's this lady right here, and she's kind of like... She totally does not approve that a black guy is with a white girl.
I'm not trying to pull anything. I was looking to find me a wife.
Ain't that just likely? You want to answer me something? What kind of doctor you supposed to be anyhow?
Would you believe horse?
Oh! You make with witticisms and all, huh? Well, let me tell you something. You may think you're fooling Miss Joey and her folks, but you ain't fooling me for a minute. You think I don't see what...
No, she's weird. She's crazy. Crazy black lady. I think the funniest part is when the maid is getting told what to do.
Everything is ready whenever you all are ready.
Yes, well, we're not ready, Tilly.
Well, Tilly, when the hell are we going to get some dinner? Manners, this is Miss Matilda Binks, who's been a member of this family for 22 years, and who today has been making a great deal of trouble. Sit down, Tilly.
You know, the guy from Up has this whole long discussion, and he's like, oh, he gives his long speech, and he pretty much just recaps the whole movie. So if you want to know what happens in the whole movie, just watch like the last 5 minutes, and that explains everything. I want to thank you all for watching, Book Haters, but this movie really sucks. Don't watch it, okay? If you do watch it, set the bar, like, there, man. Like, dude, down, okay? Seriously. Just don't watch this movie. It's not worth it. I want to thank everybody who responded to last week's question. The responses will come up shortly. Especially Naldito, who kept insisting that Ham makes him giggle. Now, it's not really a quote that you have to complete. It's kind of a quote and you have to answer the question. And it's asked by Sydney's mom. She asks,
what happens to men when they grow old?
If you want to check out the movie that I'm watching next week, which is Unforgiven, the trailer is right here. So check that out, okay? And tune in next week. I hope it's better. Now, dude, I can never say this guy's name. It's Po. Ma, ¿por qué estás hablando? That's me getting mad at my mom. This is going at the end.